The digital realm has buzzed with speculation. We've seen incredible advancements, groundbreaking releases, and now, the moment of truth is upon us. We've put aside the complex code, the endless theories, and the abstract discussions. Today, we're diving deep into the ultimate showdown to uncover the reigning champion of reasoning models. Is it the highly anticipated GPT-5, the formidable Grok 4, or the newly refined Claude Opus 4.1? The AI landscape is shifting constantly, and what was true yesterday might be history today. Just recently, Grok 4 held the crown as the top reasoning model in many circles. But has that changed with the arrival of these new titans? That's precisely what we're here to find out. Before we jump into our own comprehensive testing, let's set the stage by looking at where these three, and indeed other prominent models, stand on established reasoning benchmarks. We'll start with the latest insights directly from OpenAI. The GPQA Diamond benchmark, for instance, is widely recognized as a robust measure of reasoning capabilities. On this tough test, GPT-5 achieved an impressive score of 85.7%. Is that the best out there? Surprisingly, no. If we look at the data from Gemini 2.5 Pro, it actually edged out GPT-5 with a score of 86.4%. A slight lead, but significant in this high-stakes game. So is Gemini 2.5 Pro the ultimate leader then? Not quite. The current frontrunner on this particular benchmark is Grok 4, boasting an even higher score of 87.5%. The pattern is already starting to emerge. Now let's shift our focus to another one of my personal favorite benchmarks, Humanity's Last Exam. We're specifically looking at performance without any external tools, as that's how the benchmark is designed for raw reasoning assessment. In this challenging scenario, GPT-5 scored 24.8%. Again, the question arises, is GPT-5 the pinnacle? And once more, the answer is no. Grok 4 narrowly surpasses it with 25.4%, maintaining its lead even on this incredibly difficult test. So, across multiple well-known reasoning benchmarks, Grok 4 consistently demonstrates its superior capabilities. Finally, let's consider the RKGI leaderboard, specifically RKGI 2. Here, Grok 4's performance is remarkably ahead, scoring 16%. In contrast, GPT-5's high-setting model scored 9.9%, slightly above Claude Opus, but still a considerable distance behind Grok 4. It's worth noting, however, that on RKGI 1, some other models, like O3 Preview, have shown extremely high performance, even outperforming Grok 4 thinking. But for RKGI 2, Grok 4 stands significantly ahead of GPT-5. The trend across these three major benchmarks is clear. Grok 4 has demonstrated a consistent lead in raw reasoning power. But benchmarks tell only part of the story. To truly understand the state of the art, we need to put these models through their paces with a set of diverse, real-world, highly challenging reasoning problems. We've selected four distinct questions, one involving 64 tennis players, a complex seating arrangement puzzle, a difficult jersey number assignment, and a detailed Navy designation problem. These aren't your typical simple prompts. These are questions designed to push the boundaries of AI reasoning, problems where most other models would likely falter. We've seen scores from many other models on these questions, and they rarely perform well. For this series of tests, we have two significant new entries, GPT-5 and Claude Opus 4.1, joining our existing lineup of top-tier models. Let's break down their performance question by question. First, the 64 tennis players question. This problem requires intricate logical deduction and elimination. On this particular challenge, the highest scores previously achieved by any model were a perfect 10 out of 10, shared by O3 and Grok 4. What about GPT-5? GPT-5 managed a solid 8 out of 10. For many, this might be a slight dip from expectations given the hype around GPT-5. Now, turning our attention to the Claude Opus family. The previous Claude Opus model also scored an 8 out of 10. And what about the new Claude Opus 4.1, a version specifically refined for improved reasoning? Interestingly, it also scored an 8 out of 10. In this initial test, we don't see any significant improvement from Opus 4.1. Whether we see more notable advancements later remains to be seen. Next up, arguably one of the most challenging questions in our suite, the seating arrangement puzzle. This problem isn't just about getting the right answer. It demands the model explicitly lay out the correct seating arrangement, proving its full comprehension of the complex spatial and logical constraints. Previously, the best performer here was Grok 4, with a score of 7 out of 10, followed by OpenAI's O3 at 6 out of 10. So how did GPT-5 fare? Prepare yourselves, because the results here are truly eye-opening. GPT-5 scored an astonishing 9 out of 10. When we first saw this, we were absolutely blown away. When O3 Preview was initially released, it couldn't even score 1 out of 10 on this very question. GPT-5 nearly solved it completely. This incredible performance strongly indicates that the raw, underlying model of GPT-5, especially in its high setting, is an exceptionally intelligent entity. Now I understand the frustration many users are experiencing with the current ChatGPT interface.
I felt it too.
I'm not saying everything is perfect. For example, I tried to use GPT-5 to help build a table for presenting these scores. On the first attempt, it gave me one of the most unformatted, clunky, and frankly ugly responses I've ever seen from an AI. The table wasn't even correctly formatted, with scores jumbled together in one corner, far from their respective questions. It made silly errors I've never encountered with other models, like Gemini 2.5 Pro, which consistently handles table generation perfectly. So yes, the chat interface might be a bit erratic and have some of the issues people are discussing. But when you look at the raw power of the GPT-5 high model, it clearly demonstrates immense potential. Now, let's turn to Claude Opus 4.1 for the seating arrangement question. Before we reveal its score, a quick note on testing this model. The costs absolutely skyrocket.
I've refilled my credits numerous times.
Just halfway through our tests, we burned through over $25 just on Opus 4.1. To put that into perspective, Opus's output pricing is roughly 7.5 times pricier than GPT-5. You could effectively build a GPT-5 heavy system with 6 agents and a 7th to combine their outputs, and it would still likely be cheaper than using Opus for the same task. That's how expensive it is to test and use. So, with that in mind, how did Opus 4.1 perform on the seating arrangement question? Remember, GPT-5 scored an incredible 9 out of 10, surpassing Grok 4's 7. The previous Claude Opus scored a 0 out of 10 on this.
And Opus 4.1!
It also scored a 0 out of 10. Clearly, despite its hefty price tag, this model struggles significantly with complex reasoning. Perhaps this is why Anthropic seems to be focusing so heavily on coding applications. Either they initially intended to train it for coding, or the model naturally excelled there while falling short in reasoning, prompting a strategic pivot. The results, regardless, speak for themselves. Moving on to our third challenge, the jersey number question. This is another incredibly difficult problem, where the model must correctly assign jersey numbers to specific players based on intricate clues and constraints. Previous top performers here were Deep Sea Car and O4 Mini High, both scoring a modest 2 out of 10. OpenAI's O3 managed 1 out of 10. What about GPT-5? In this instance, GPT-5 scored a 0 out of 10. It fell slightly behind O3 here. While it had a spectacular showing in the seating arrangement question, it demonstrates that even top models have areas where they might struggle. Now for Claude Opus 4.1 on the jersey number question. The previous Claude Opus scored 1 out of 10. Did the new version show any improvement?
Yes!
Opus 4.1 scored a 2 out of 10. This is the first question where we see a tangible, albeit marginal, improvement in Opus's reasoning capabilities. Crucially, it didn't seem to lose any of its previous abilities or intelligence in other areas, which is a good sign, unlike some other models that seem to be a bit inconsistent. Finally, we come to the Navy designation question. Here, the task is to assign correct designations to specific individuals based on a set of rules and relationships. On this test, Grok 4 once again achieved a perfect 10 out of 10. OpenAI's O3 scored 5 out of 10. And GPT-5? It scored an impressive 9 out of 10. Once again, GPT-5 makes up for any previous shortcomings, gaining significant ground here. This brings its total score across our 4 tests to 26 out of 40. Let's look at Claude Opus 4.1 for this final question. The original Claude Opus scored 9 out of 10 on this very test. This question was actually introduced because there was a lot of debate about whether Claude Opus was truly an intelligent model. It performed very well on it then.
What about Opus 4.1?
It also scored a 9 out of 10. So, across most of our tests, the scores for Opus 4.1 have been largely identical to its predecessor, with just that one point improvement on the jersey number question, This gives Claude Opus 4.1 a total score of 19 out of 40, a slight improvement over Claude Opus's 18. Comparing O3 and GPT-5, O3 scored 22 out of 40, while GPT-5 scored 26 out of 40. That's a significant 4-point improvement for GPT-5, clearly showcasing its advancement over the previous OpenAI iteration. So after all the rigorous testing, the numbers are in. When we sort the models by their total scores, the smartest reasoning model in our current assessment remains Grok 4, achieving an impressive 27 out of 40. And hot on its heels, a very close second, is GPT-5 with a score of 26 out of 40. It is what it is. Grok 4 has proven to be marginally better in our extensive testing, a finding that aligns with many other reasoning benchmarks we've discussed. However, there's an important caveat to understand about Grok 4. It's a very thoughtful model. It can take a significant amount of time, sometimes up to 15 or even 18 minutes, to come up with a response, and it consumes a lot of tokens, making it pricier to run. While its responses are often excellent, if time is a critical constraint for your application, Grok 4 might not be the ideal choice. We've found ourselves in situations where, despite knowing Grok 4 is the smartest, its inference time makes it impractical for certain real-time uses. Interestingly, we've also observed that even GPT-5 can sometimes take a considerable amount of time to think. We've seen instances where GPT-5 was processing a query for over 14 minutes. This is a new development that we didn't typically see with O3, which generally responded faster. So, while not all the time, GPT-5 also seems to have a tendency to engage in deeper, longer thought processes. In summary, based on our in-depth analysis and custom testing, Grok 4 continues to hold the title as the best reasoning model. However, the difference between Grok 4 and GPT-5 is incredibly slim, just 1 point. This narrow margin suggests a fierce competition and rapid evolution in the AI space. We'll continue to refine our reasoning tests and explore new methodologies to capture the nuances of these incredible models. To stay at the forefront of AI developments, to get the latest leaks, testing insights, and expert analysis, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on all notifications. We strive to be the first to bring you breaking news and comprehensive insights, keeping you updated on everything from new model releases to early benchmarks. We hope this deep dive has provided you with clear, actionable information about the current state of leading reasoning models, where they stand, their strengths, their weaknesses, and their practical implications. If you found this information valuable, please give this video a like, subscribe to the channel, and join our community.
We'll catch you in the next one!